Namaste Yatirajaya Vivekananda Suraye Tachit Sukha Sarupayo Swamine Tapoharine. Most revered President Maharaj, revered Swami Prabhananda Ji Maharaj, and revered Swami Gautamananda Ji Maharaj, Vice Presidents of Ramakrishna Math and Ramakrishna Mission. Very dear Sri Vivek Devroy, our alumnus and Chairman, Economic Advisory Council to the Prime Minister of India. Swami Purnatmananda Ji, Head of our Center in Dhaka. My colleague Swami Balabhadrananda Ji, revered Vice President Maharaj, sitting off the dais. Revered Swami Sivamayananda Ji Maharaj and revered Swami Suhitananda Ji Maharaj. Revered elders, brother monks and brahmacharins, our distinguished alumni, Sri Barindra Sanyal from TCS, Sri Jagdish Gopalan, a very outstanding, renowned professor in Institute of Science, Bangalore. Justice Koteshwar Singh from Guwahati High Court. Padma Awardee Sri Nali Kuposwami Chetty. Retired Justice of Patna High Court, Justice Shailesh Singh. Excuse me, Justice Shailesh Sinha. Dr. H.V. Jindal, a very renowned physician of our country, located in Chandigarh. Sri Tapan Mishra, senior advisor to the chairman of ISRO, Bangalore. And Sri Sujit Kumar Sarkar, formerly Director General of Police, Government of West Bengal, Kolkata, who are here on our request. And last but not least, our ex-students who have come from all parts of the country. I extend a warm and hearty welcome to all of you on this crisp winter morning to the first ever All India Alumni Meet of the Ramakrishna Math and Ramakrishna Mission held at the holy precincts of Belur Math. I also take this opportunity to extend my cordial welcome to General Jarkin Gamlin, a Major General of our Armed Forces, and Sri Alapan Bandopadhyay, Additional Chief Secretary and Secretary Home to the Government of West Bengal, who will join this alumni meet tomorrow. I especially welcome a large number of visually challenged alumni from our Narendrapur Ashrama, who have come to attend this program with great enthusiasm. Another small but significant group is our lady delegates. I welcome them with due respect, dignity, and grace. I offer my Sashtanga pranams at the holy feet of Most Revered President Maharaj and seek his blessings on all of us. My humble pranams to all the senior monks and love and best wishes to my younger monastic brothers. Sri Ramakrishna used to climb to the top of a building named Kuti at the Dakshineshwar Kali temple and call for young men with great longing to come to him. Responding to his call, youth led by Narendranath Dutta, later Swami Vivekananda and others, who would eventually accept his teachings and carry forward his message, came to Thakur. We believe that the eternal call is still reverberating across time and space, attracting young men and women into his fold. In one way or another, all of you have also responded to that call and stepped into the portals of the Ramakrishna, portals of a Ramakrishna Mission Center as a young child or as a college-going youth. Many are called, but few are chosen, they say. You are the chosen few, fortunate few. Whether you realize it or not, the blessing of Sri Ramakrishna is on all of you. All of you are part of the Ramakrishna movement. On this happy occasion, we recall the noble act of your parents who were instrumental in putting you at Ramakrishna Mission. You should be eternally grateful to them for this precious gift that has yoked you to a mighty spiritual movement. Yes, Ramakrishna Mission is not just a place for imparting secular knowledge, but it is a place of man-making, as Swamiji envisioned. All of you assembled here have witnessed the truth of the statement in your own life, I am sure about it. In Latin, the word alma mater literally means generous or bountiful mother. True to the spirit of this word, our institutions have nurtured you at a very important phase of your life with love and care. The strength of the bond thus formed between the students and their alma maters and amongst themselves has stood the test of time. The very fact that nearly 3,000 of you have assembled here from all parts of India and abroad is a standing testimony to the living, vibrant connection that exists between us. Just as a spiritual organization is admired for the number of saints it produces, an academic institution is known for the quality of the students who have passed through its portals, who later blossom into good citizens. By that yardstick, we can be reasonably proud of our accomplishments over the last 100 years. There is a greater public appreciation of our efforts in providing quality education with stress on values. Today, there is a great need for competent individuals who are socially committed, morally strong, and spiritually rooted in their traditions. And Ramakrishna Mission, in its own inevitable ways, is silently fulfilling the need at the command of its leader, Swami Vivekananda, by providing man-making, character-building education to the youth of this country. In the context of an educational institution, compared to the students, guardians, teaching and non-teaching staff, it is the association of the alumni with their alma mater that is more permanent, more sustainable, should I say. In our context, monks are posted out, students pass out, staff members superannuate, retire, but the alumni remain connected to the institution and remains an alumni till the last breath of his life. Thus, alumni becomes a more sustainable and the most sustainable factor in the entire scheme of things. As a result, they have a greater role to play in the development of their alma maters. Our centers too have to realize the importance of involving ex-students for the growth of their institutions and should accord due respect and importance to the alumni activities. The ex-students should feel wanted when they visit their alma maters. Both our institutions and the alumni associations should work in tandem with a mutual feeling of love and esteem for one another. The alumni meet was long overdue. That we hadn't organized such a conference till now is a surprise. I must admit, we have failed to pay much attention to our alumni. Many centers still do not have an alumni association. We have not taken proactive steps to connect with our alumni. When Swami Vivekananda went to the West, he was very impressed by the power of organization in Western countries. Swamiji wanted to mobilize all forces of goodness for the greater welfare of humanity. We need to work in an organized way with our ex-students. The diverse resources of our alumni community have to be tapped for the good of all, for the welfare of all. Every year, more than 2 lakh students pass out from the portals of Ramakrishna Mission institutions in India and abroad. The vast alumni community that now exists, scattered across continents, has to be brought under one roof. It's an idea whose time has come. The alumni meet is a small step in the direction. So many bright and brilliant minds with vast experience of the world have assembled here. I place before you a few questions. Let's brainstorm and find out the way forward. Number one, how to stay connected? How to bring all our ex-students under one roof? Is it feasible? Number two, how to mobilize the alumni community and strengthen the bonds with their alma maters? Number three, how shall we establish synergy between various alumni associations so that we multiply our capacity for doing good? Four, how to discharge our responsibility to the society and help the Ramakrishna movement in its endeavors? Five, there is a sweeping change in the education sector today. How can the alumni help us in adapting to the fast changes in the education landscape? How they can benefit the current generation of students? These are some of the questions that may be discussed in our formal and informal deliberations over the next 2 days. I heartily welcome all of you, particularly those who have come from other parts of India and abroad, who have responded to our invitation and have come today, setting aside other pressing engagements. We have tried our best to make this day comfortable for our residential delegates. I hope you won't mind any difficulty, as this is your own place. I invite you all to freely and actively take part in the deliberations and enjoy the refreshing stay at the cradle of spirituality that is Belur Math. We hope, by the grace of Sri Sri Thakur, this conference will go down in history as a pivotal assembly that brought about momentous changes for good in future. Offering my devoted pranams to most revered President Maharaj and other Vice President Maharajis, I once again welcome Sri Vivek Dev Roy, our distinguished alumni, who will speak in this session, and all the ex-students, their family members, our moms, our friends in media, and to this All India Alumni Meet, all our delegates, all our ex-students. Sarve sukhino bhavantu, sarve santu niramayaha, sarve bhadrani pasyantu, ma kaschit dukham apnuvat. Let all be happy, let all be free from ailments, let all be blessed with the vision of truth, beauty and goodness, let misery touch none. Jai Swamiji Maharaj ji ki jai.